On this 40th anniversary of the Equal Rights Amendment being approved by this Congress, I cannot help but wonder how things might have been different if the ERA had actually been ratified by enough states all these years ago and become part of our Constitution, and how attitudes and treatment and respect towards women would be different simply because it was valued and included in our Constitution. Because if equality had been enshrined in the Constitution for these past 40 years, I wonder if we would still be hearing today from right-wing presidential candidates and contenders that say women should not serve in the military, that women should think twice before they seek to work outside of the home, and that women should not use birth control, and that women who do are called very bad names that are not fit to repeat now. And I wonder if we would be having congressional hearings that focus solely on the issue of women's reproductive rights and health care, and we look out and see an all-male panel where we have to ask the obvious, where are the women? I wonder if the ERA had been approved by the necessary number of states and ratified into law and become part of our Constitution, that we could have saved women from being charged more than men for health care, a problem we have solved now with the Affordable Care Act. Right here in Congress, we've had an array of bills that would have a devastating impact on the health and lives of women. Just women, mind you, not men, just women. It's true, most of these would not have been corrected by the ERA, but would attitudes have been so different that no one would have dared to even bring them up? We have had that effort to defund Planned Parenthood, which is a primary health provider for millions of women across our country. We've had that effort to pass the Blunt Amendment that would have outlawed many widely used safe and effective means of birth control. From Montana to Arizona to New Hampshire and Virginia, similar regressive efforts have been proposed or passed, which roll back the privacy between a woman and her doctor, or slash funding for women's health care needs. When you look at these efforts from 10,000 feet, it's a pattern here in Congress and all across the country. And ask yourself if this doesn't smack of an all-out assault on women's right to make her own health decisions. I think it's time to declare loud and proud that we will not march meekly back to that primitive and dark age. I think it's time to declare that this will be another year of the woman at the polls. I think it's time to stop fighting discrimination against women piecemeal, one small skirmish at a time. And I think it's time to make equality for women not just a slogan, but in a constitutional reality embedded in our Constitution. I think it's time to pass the ERA. Yes. Thank you. Yes.